Hey everyone, I hope you're all doing well. My name is Greg and welcome back to another Wix video. This one is going to dissect the anatomy of a Wix website. And what I mean by that is how to use the backgrounds, the layers, different objects, and different elements on your Wix website. This can be a little bit confusing for beginners, so what I wanna do is jump in the computer and just go through everything kind of step by step and show you how to use these elements and how they interact together. So without further ado, let's get in the computer and walk through this. All right, so here we are just on the example website that I've been creating and using for some of these YouTube tutorials. And what I wanna show you is strips and backgrounds first. So first things first is these are all strips. So on a lot of the templates, you will find strips. And what they are, you can add them over here and you go to strip and it's basically a type of element. And it's like a page of a website, if you will. So what this is in action is this is a strip right here. It's kind of a landing page strip. And then the next one down is the services section strip here. And then we have the about strip and the contact strip. They're all separate strips. Now, if we come up to the top and we zoom out here, we get a better idea of what these strips are and how they're separated. So we have the first strip here and then the next strip. And all of these are individual strips. So at any point, we can delete these strips and replace them with other things. So I'm just going to zoom back into our site here. And if we need to delete a strip, all we have to do is just click on that strip to select it and just hit the delete or backspace button. And then that strip is completely gone. And now we're left with the background of the website. So this is where the strips are sitting on top of. So as you can see, all of these strips were touching each other before, so you couldn't see this white background here. So as you can see, you can't see the white at all because all of these strips are touching. Now, if we were to slide one of these strips up, just clicking it and dragging it up, you can see that the background is still back there. So that's the difference between a background and a strip. And just know that strips are the nice, easy way that Wix gives us where we can just plug in elements and create kind of pages or sections, but you can always add elements to the background just like this. You don't have to use strips. So if you do want to create something like an About Us page, you can do it one of two ways. So I'm going to use this section right here of our background to show you. You can come over to Add, and you can go to strip and you can find an about us right here and you can just click any of these and it'll drop it right in. Let's see where that added that to our page. So it'll drop it right into our page. Now, what we were trying to do was add it to this white space right here. So the best way to move that up there is actually to hit this zoom out and then we'll be able to drag it right into that gap. So I'm gonna grab it from down here and I'm gonna drag it up. There's one, I'm gonna drag it up one more. And now we have it in this gap right here in the right spot. And then we can just do one of two things. Either we can drag to close the space of the background here, or we can just hit delete space. And now what we've done when we close out of this is we've just added our about section right to that white gap of the background that we were just talking about previously. Now, if we don't want to add a strip here, we can click on the strip and we can delete it with the backspace or delete button again. And we can manually add in elements here. So there's one of two ways you can do this. Either you can come right over here and you can just add in the elements that you'd like. If we want to add in a header, we can just click any of these headers right here and it'll add it right to our website. It's in white text, so I'm just going to hit edit and I'm going to switch that to black so we can see it. And then I'm going to make it bigger and we'll just slide this out. And now we can start to create basically an about us page however we would like it. Now the other way you can do this is you can just click on that, delete it. We can come right to this and we can right click, copy it, and come down here, right click and paste it. And if you like the look of that text right here, you can recreate it with this. That way you can make your sections look similar. So you have the same font, the same color, and then you can just start copying text and copying any elements you want to put right onto the background. Now, something to note here is you can change the color of this background and it'll change the color of the background throughout the entire website. So if we were to change this background, all we have to do is change page background, go to color, and then we can switch it to, let's make it a blue right now. And now you'll see with this, when we start to move these elements and it exposes the background, all of it will be that blue. Now, again, with all of these things here, if you did something that you didn't want to do, all you have to do is hit back. And then if you want to change that back to white again, you can either go and do it manually and change it to white, or we could have just hit the back arrow again right up here and it would have switched it and undone the changes we made prior. So that's the first thing. That's the difference between strips and your background. And now I kind of want to talk about layers. This is typically the next thing that becomes kind of a question when you're putting something on a page, but you can't see it, or it's partially hidden or covered up by another item. So this is a common thing and it's easy to fix. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show you two things. I'm going to add two elements to the page, and then I'm going to show you how you can switch which one shows and which one's on top of the other one. So first thing, we're just going to add a button here. Just a simple button, and we'll put that over here. And then I'm going to come in and add a shape, and I'll just add this shape right here. So now we can see that when we put one on top of the other, one is going to be on top of the other and one will be hidden. Now all we have to do here to expose this one on top of this one is we just right click it and we do arrange, and we can say bring to front, and this will bring it all the way to the front. Now if you have multiple items here, so if I add one more button, I'm just going to right click and I'm going to duplicate this button. So now we have a third button. So now we technically have three layers here. So we can decide what is in front of what. So if we want to take this and we want it to be in the middle of these two buttons, we can right click it, arrange, and clearly it's all the way in the back right now. So we can move forward, or we can bring to front. If you bring to front, it'll move it in front of every single item. So it'll bring it all the way to the front and then it'll be in front of everything. Now let's go back one. If we were to right click and arrange and just move forward once, you click it one time and see what happened. Okay, that brought this one in front of there. So now we can use this one as the front and we can use this one as the back. And you just play with this until you find the order. So you can always change. So if you know you want this one all the way in the back, you can right click it, you can arrange, and you can send to the back. It'll go all the way to the back of everything. And remember, your background is always going to be the default all the way back. You can't put anything behind the background. So just know that if something's hidden, just right click it and go to arrange and see where it is in the order and move it forward or move it back or bring it all the way to the front or all the way to the back. So that's a really good thing to keep in mind if you have something that's hidden like an image, or you want buttons on top of shapes and especially text, things like that. So as always, just make sure that you go onto mobile before you finish anything up and see how it all looks on mobile. You want to make sure that everything looks good on mobile as well, because it won't line up exactly the same as it is on desktop here. So just keep that in mind, double check mobile and make sure that everything looks good here before you publish your changes and make that live. So hopefully that helps you guys a little bit and helps you understand the anatomy of Wix websites and the elements, how backgrounds and strips and layers all work together with each other, and how you can arrange them in front or behind each other. If you have any questions about putting your Wix website together, feel free to leave it in the comments. And as always, if you like this video, feel free to give it a thumbs up or subscribe to the channel for more. All right, guys, I hope you like this one and I will see you in the next one.